Hi, my name is Danielle, and I'm here to teach you a little bit of a upper cervical, shoulder, and neck release slash restore class. We're going to start today with our black strap. So the black spinal strip will be folded into the length of the palm of your hand. And the position for the black strap is directly in between the shoulder blades. Feel the structure of your neck, and as you run your fingertips down that structure, you'll run into a large bone. That's the bottom of your cervical spine. We want this double folded black strap to be below that large bone. In other words, in between the shoulder blades. The most effective way to lower down is to hold onto either side of that black strap, bend your knees, and as you exhale, roll yourself down until the black strap meets the floor, and then raise your hips up into what we call a little bridge posture, and let the weight of your head settle down onto the single portion of your black strap. Now, before you lower your hips, do a little check and ensure that the black strap is indeed not pushing into your neck, but is below that large bone. Place your hands onto your forehead, fingertips towards the crown, elbows towards the ceiling, and then close your eyes and just begin to settle the weight of your body into that black strap. The purpose of the black strap is to help us realign the spine. Constant pressure with the weight of the head and the shoulders rolling forward create a lot of pressure and tissue buildup on the back of the spine. This is clinically known as a kyphosis. And the only way to really begin to affect something like a kyphosis is to apply pressure. Begin to change the load story. Take a nice deep breath. Apply a little bit more pressure into your strap by pressing your feet into the floor, or by simply allowing the weight of your body and your breath to move into that pressure. And then allow the back of your pelvis and the back of your ribs to slowly move down towards the floor. And focus on feeling the increase of pressure and the inward movement of your spine as your pelvis settles towards the ground. Note the importance of moving slowly here in order to make sure that the weight and the pressure of the movement travels as deeply into the body as possible. Once your pelvis reaches the floor, take your hands onto your lower ribs, pick up your head and lengthen your neck. And then allow the weight of your hands to softly guide your ribs down towards the floor. Please note, this is a movement of settling, not an active movement of pressing the ribs down. Take a breath down towards the lower belly. And exhale the weight of your shoulder blades, collarbone, spine and head into the support of the floor or the strap. With your next inhalation, imagine growing tall into the crown of your head. Relax your jaw and begin to turn your head towards the right. And imagine that you have a ball on top of a flagpole. And you're simply spinning or turning the ball on the very top of the flagpole. So your head is not going to tip, nor is it going to roll off the strap. You're simply working rotation of the upper cervical spine as you bring your ear to align with the strap. Once the movement of the head stops, bring your attention back to your breath, breathing deeply into the belly, settling and softening the weight of the ribs towards the floor. and just explore the possibility of engaging into a little more length in order to potentially afford a little bit more rotation. Roll your head back into center. Inhale from the tip of your tailbone into the crown of your head. Ensure the jaw is loose on its hinge, and then rotate your head into the other direction. Continue to imagine your spine is growing longer as your head rotates to the left. Feel the evenness and the weight of your feet against the floor. Breathe into the lower belly to allow your lower back to lift softly, naturally, and gently from the floor. Apply the weight of that exhale into the ribs and upper back. And then give yourself on your next inhale a little bit more length. And then a little bit more rotation might occur. Continue to remind yourself to relax and stay soft and heavy. And then turn your head back into the center. And now just allow your head to rotate back to the right, but this time it will tip off the edge of the strap and it will move all the way down towards or onto the floor. Now, if the head isn't touching the floor, it simply means the weight of the head is being supported by your tension, by your own structure, your own shape. You can actually yield the weight of your head into that tension and gradually, slowly, the fascia around the front of the neck and the shoulder will begin to remodel itself. The grip on the muscles will begin to release, and the head will softly move a little bit deeper towards the side. And then push softly into the back of your head as you roll back into center. Again, ensuring the jaw is loose on its hinge, rotate your head towards the left. Remind yourself to slowly yield into any lines of tension or resistance. Don't force the body. You're just negotiating a place of softness and relaxation and presence of mind. While you begin to attune yourself to the sensations that the tissue presents, you can allow your breath to travel into those areas, those sensations. And letting the head just roll back into the center. With an inhalation from here, we'll stretch our arms up towards the ceiling. And we'll simply interlace our fingers loosely. With another inhalation, reach your arms up towards the ceiling. And just close your eyes and notice how the pushing of the arms begins to change the shape of your spine. It actually increases the kyphosis in the upper back. The neck begins to arch and move away from the black strap, and the lower back begins to drop towards the floor. Without making any other corrections, just allow the weight of your arms to settle back in towards your shoulder blades. It's almost like you're softly letting the arms drop in towards the shoulder blades. Sinking feeling, if you will. And then nod your chin towards your chest to take up the slack in your neck. And then begin to lower the arms overhead. Now the intention here is not to bring the hands or the arms to the floor at this point, but it's to notice where tightness where difficulty in the movement pattern presents itself. And what happens is the movement begins to slow down. The slowing down will turn into a cessation of movement eventually. And I want you to just hold your arms here, breathing. Breathe the breath into the belly. Allow the ribs to expand, open, press outwards with your inhales. And remember that heaviness of the structure of the body when you exhale. With your next inhalation, begin to lengthen your arms away from you. At this point, don't change the angle that your arms are sitting in. Just begin to reach outwards. Notice and feel the landscape of that movement, the tissue that's being affected through the ribs, through the spine. And allow your arms to move back a little bit further. Eventually, they'll come to the next stopping point, where a gentle breath in the pot of the belly will allow the lower back to unwind and relax a little more. The arms are resting in that line or supportive tension. And they'll begin to lengthen the fabric of the body again by reaching the arms away from us slowly. Start to imagine that as you move your arms, you are moving your vertebra into a longer position. And then the arms will travel back a little bit further. And there'll be another stop somewhere around the level of your eyebrows, temples, or ears. And you'll just hold. And then with an inhalation, bring your arms back up. We're going to go all the way back down to the point that we were just at again. So without taking a rest at the bus stops along the way, we'll just find our way all the way down to that last movement that we just settled into. And back up. And back down. Back up. From here, take a hold of your right wrist with your index finger and thumb and begin to pull your right arm up towards the ceiling. And once that arm is on traction, gently circle the arm and the shoulder joint. Explore some nice circular global movements of the shoulder. Of course, we're affecting quite a few joints in the right arm right now. We're affecting the glenohumeral joint, which is your arm bone, into your shoulder socket, and we're affecting the scapular thoracic joint, which is the shoulder blade on the back of the rib cage. We're also affecting the way the collarbone or the clavicle articulates with the sternum and the shoulder. The right arm should be fairly passive as you do this. And then we're going to go ahead and bring that left elbow all the way down to the floor on the left side of the body. And we'll pull the arms off to the side as the knees lean into the opposite direction. And you have the option of allowing your head to follow the movement of your arms or keeping your head positioned into the center of the strap. And then just let that left elbow leave the floor and bring that right arm up to 12 o'clock. So it's extending out over the crown of your head. Perhaps the knees will lean a little bit further to the right. Breathe into the side line, the space through the ribs, through the belly. And then bend your elbows, rock your knees and your head back into center. And then switching arms by taking a hold of the left wrist between the index finger and the thumb. Beginning to traction the left arm up towards the ceiling. And then we'll create some gentle rotations of the arm here. And you have a strong anatomy base of knowledge. You can visualize those different joints that are moving, or you can simply feel a smooth, articular, global, and circular movement your tongue relaxed, the jaw unhinged, and then we'll move on to the other side, bringing the right elbow down to the floor beside us, and beginning to pull on the arm, a little more traction. And let the knees drift off to the left. Feel a little bit of a counter pull through your spine. The knees are almost resisting the movement of the arm. Take a deep breath into the pot of the belly and then allow the right elbow to leave the floor and to stretch that left arm up overhead. And bend your elbows and bring the body back into center. And to finish up, we'll do a nice rotation. So just bring the sides of your feet to touching. Stretch your arms all the way out to the side and spin the palms of your hands down into the floor. With an inhalation, raise your left foot. And as you exhale, rotate your knees to the right, bringing the weight of the legs onto the outer edge of the right foot. And as the knees are dropping down to the side, open across the front of your chest and belly, and let your head move towards your left arm. A nice free breath from pubic bone all the way up to collarbones. Bringing your knees back into the center, allowing your left foot to land on the ground, raise your right foot up. Nice deep breath in, and as you exhale, let those knees slowly rotate down to the left. And allow your head to roll off to the right. Wherever you feel tension, direct your breath like you could expand the inner space in your body by focusing on the movement of your breath. And then bring your knees back into center, bend your elbows, roll onto your side. Now for those of you who have a felt pad, you can roll the felt pad from the long end. You can also use your black strap folded in half. I'm going to use the felt pad so that I can also use the black strap against my lower back. But if you don't have both tools, please know that instead of doing this, you can just fold your black strap in half and place it behind your body and lower yourself down so the bottom tips of your shoulder blades are just ahead of the roll. So that means the actual body of my shoulder blade is free from any pressure or contact with the roll. Then if you have the black strap, you're welcome to just slide that under the natural curvature of your lower back to provide a little bit of traction through your spine. And then we'll support the weight of the head as we sink and settle the weight of the upper body into the felt pad. And again, working to progressively and gradually change the way our spine holds its position in gravity. We're applying a load onto the spine. And we're relaxing and settling and giving ourselves some time. Taking breaths into the belly. It's almost like you're yawning, melting, yielding in. Lengthen the neck from the area between the shoulder blades. Keep your eyes liquid soft. Jaw unhinged. Allow yourself to settle really slowly down to the floor. And once the back of your head is touching the ground, you can bring your arms into a cowboy surrender position. You can give yourself a couple of breaths here, just letting the back of your ribs settle towards the props on the floor. Allowing the breath in your belly to make your lower back light to the black strap if you're using it. And then stretch your right leg all the way out from the hip and through the knee joint and place the back of the leg onto the floor. And then bring your left foot on top of your right thigh. And do a little bit of a shift to take the weight of your body onto the outside of your straight legs. So you're going to be stacking your right hip under your left hip. Now let the weight of that leg carry your torso into rotation. And when the movement stops, take a breath. And begin to very gently, without allowing that left arm to leave the floor, just start to stretch it out towards 12 o'clock. And start to notice as the arm gets longer, the twist gets a little deeper. And then pulse back out, bringing your elbow back to a 90 degree bend and rolling out of the movement slightly. And this is your exploration and movement. Keeping your eyes closed, begin to explore stretching and rotating at the same time. You could feel where the tension is and gently breathe and move into it. Again, the idea not to force, harden, or try to correct any misalignment or tissue tension, but rather honoring and coaxing a little bit of limitation and then inviting a little bit of change. Try the inhale, which helps you expand and lengthen. And then moving back into center to bring your left foot to the floor and your pelvis back to the center. And then extend your left leg out and place your right foot across your thigh. Stack your left hip bone underneath your right hip bone. And then as you exhale, yield into that rotation. When the movement stops, the arm starts. Begin sliding the arm away from you. Allowing the inside of the knee to move to the floor and rolling out a little bit. And stretching, inhaling, yielding, moving, and coming back up. It helps you to visualize a little pull in the weave of a sweater. You could imagine that you're starting to even out the weave through the side of your body. And then rotating back into center, we'll step the feet onto the ground. We'll move the black strap off to the side, bring the felt pad down to the lower back. Now we want to make sure that the back of the pelvis is about an inch away from the ground, so the felt pad is really close to the lowest lumbar vertebra on your spine, and your hands will position themselves over the lower ribs again to prevent the lower ribs from lifting and flaring and the back to tighten. Instead, we're going to let the lower back melt into the pressure of the roll. Then we're going to start to allow the tip of the tailbone to move towards the floor. So in this case, for those of you who were using the black strap, I'll just switch out so you can see that the black strap can also be used underneath the lower back, folded in half, and provide a very, very similar experience to the felt pad. So if you only have the one tool, we're just letting the lower back release over the prop underneath us. We're inviting that relaxed extension through the lumbar spine. The muscles on either side of the lower back are just also lengthening to support the downward movement of the hips. There's breath in the lower belly. There's a softness to the lower ribs. And then we'll take the feet together. And without allowing the soles of the feet to tip away from the floor this time, we'll lean the knees to the right. We'll just feel the pressure of the felt pad or the black strap pressing delicately into the musculature to the right of the lumbar spine. And if we bring some breath into our pinky and ring fingers, we'll start to facilitate change on the deeper level. Not resisting, not forcing, simply melting or yielding into tissue. And then allow your knees to come back into center and lean them into the other direction. So this last exercise can last as long as you need or want it to. You can begin with a 1 or 2 minute hold on each side. And then you can just simply rock the knees back and forth a few times. But this should help with any chronic low back pain or congestion. I'll sign off now and leave you with this little series of exercises to tune you up in between your visits to yoga therapy and body work.